What'd you say?
He was my brother, 5 years older than I. He was my brother, 23 years old the day he died. Freedom rider, they cursed my brother to his face. Go home, outsider, Mississippi's gonna be your burying place. Singing on his knees, an angry mob trailed along. They shot my brother dead because he hated what was wrong. Was my brother. Tears can't bring him back to me. He was my brother, and he died so his brothers could be free. Oh God, he died so his brothers could be free.
Thank you very much. I am Artie Garfunkel, and on my left is Paul Simon, who is the songwriter in the group. He's written all the songs that we'll do today, and this is called Leaves That Are Green.
I was 21 years when I wrote this song. 22 now, but I won't be for long. Time hurries on, and the leaves that are green turn to brown, and they wither with the wind, and they crumble in your hand. Once my heart was filled with the love of a girl. I held her close, but she faded in the night, like a poem I meant to write. And the leaves that are green turn to brown, and they wither with the wind, and they crumble in your hand. I threw a pebble in a brook and watched the ripples run away, and they never made a sound. And the leaves that are green turned to brown, and they wither with the wind, and they crumble in your hand. Hello, 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 hello. Goodbye, 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 goodbye. That's all there is. And the leaves that are green turn to brown.
This is a song called A Most Peculiar Man. Could you hold this for me?
You're all right.
This is a song called A Most Peculiar Man. The seeds of the song were planted one day. I was living in Hampstead, naturally, in London, and I read an article in the paper about a man who had committed suicide. Like four lines, little box, and such. And I thought it was a rather bad eulogy. See, bad way to go out. So that's the basis of this song called A Most Peculiar Man.
He was a most peculiar man. That's what Mrs. Reardon says, and she should know. She lived upstairs from him. She said he was a most peculiar man. He was a most peculiar man. He lived all alone within a house, within a room, within himself. A most peculiar man. He had no friends. He seldom spoke, and no one in turn ever spoke to him, 'cause he wasn't friendly and he didn't care. And he wasn't like them. Oh no, he was a most peculiar man. He died last Saturday. He turned on the gas and he went to sleep with the windows closed, so he'd never wake up to a silent world in his tiny room. And Mrs. Reardon says he has a brother somewhere who should be notified soon. And all the people said, what a shame that he's dead. But wasn't he a most peculiar man?
I'm sitting in the railway station, got a ticket for my destination. On a tour of one night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. Homeward bound.
wish I was homeward bound. Home, where my thoughts are skipping. Home, where my music's playing. Home, where my love lies waiting silently for me. Every day's an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines. And each town looks the same to me, the movies and the factories. And every stranger's face I see reminds me that I long to be homeward bound. I wish I was homeward bound. Home, where my thoughts escape at home, where my music's playing home, where my love lies waiting silently for me. Tonight I'll sing my songs again, I'll play the game and pretend. But all my words come back to me in shades of mediocrity, like emptiness in harmony. I need someone to comfort me. Homeward bound, I wish I was homeward bound. Home, where my thoughts are skipping. Home, where my music's playing. Home, where my love lies waiting silently for me. Silently for me.
This is a song about a girl that is fictitious. Her name is Emily. Neither of us know her, but the song is written about her. I'm sure that she will appear someday. The song is called For Emily, Whenever I May Find Her.
Dressed in organdy, clothed in crinoline of smoky burgundy, softer than the rain. I wandered empty streets down past the shop displays. I heard cathedral bells tripping down the alleyways as I walked on. And when you ran to me, your cheeks flushed with the night. We walked on frosted fields of juniper and lamplight. I held your hand. And when I woke and felt you warm and near, I kissed your honey hair with my grateful tears. Oh, I love you, girl. Oh, I love you.
switch. Oh, nah. Let's do another one. This is a song that took us, of all the songs in the collection, this is the one that took the longest time to write. And in fact, it took us the longest time to record in the studios. It's really our favorite song, called The Dangling Conversation.
Late afternoon, as the sun shines through the curtain lace and shadows wash the room, and we sit and drink our coffee, couched in our indifference like shells upon the shore. You can hear the ocean roar in the dangling conversation and the superficial signs, the borders of our lives. And you read your Emily Dickinson, and I my Robert Frost, and we note our place with bookmarkers that measure what we've lost. Like a poem poorly written, we are verses out of rhythm, couplets out of rhyme, in syncopated time, and the dangling conversation and the superficial sighs are the borders of our lives. Yes, we speak of things that matter with words that must be said. Can analysis be worthwhile? Is the theater really dead? And how the room has softly faded, and I only kiss your shadow. I cannot feel your hand. You're a stranger now unto me, lost in the dangling conversation and the superficial sigh in the borders of our lives.
Can you feel that? Huh? Did you not?
I returned to the United States in December of 1965 after living a year here in England. And I went back because The Sounds of Silence had become a big hit, you see. So I returned. So, but I had to make this like adjustment, this transition from being sort of relatively unknown in England to being semi-famous type scene in the States, you see. And, wow, there's ghosts on the stage, man.
You know what happened? The string popped out by itself. That's what it looks like, anyway. I see the peg just jumped right up.
So here I am back in the States, very depressed, really, very down with the whole scene, and all the songs I was writing, same category down. Until like last June, I started to swing out and get into a better mood. One day, I'm coming over like the 59th Street Bridge in New York. And very groovy day it was, about 6 o'clock in the morning. You know, and it's one of those times when you know you're not gonna be tired for about an hour. Good good times. So I started writing this song, which later became the 59th Street Bridge song, or Feeling Groovy.
Slow down, you move too fast. You got to make the morning last. Just kicking down the cobblestones, looking for fun and feeling groovy. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da, feeling groovy. Hello lamppost, what you knowin'? I come to watch your flowers growin'. Ain't you got no rhymes to me? Do-do-do, feeling groovy. I got no deeds to do, no promises to keep. I'm dappled and drowsy and ready to sleep. Let the morning time drop all its petals on me. Life, I love you, all is groovy.
This is a song which is an adaptation of an Edwin Arlington Robinson poem written many years back. It's called Richard Cory.
They say that Richard Cory owns one half of this whole town, with political connections to spread his wealth around. Born into society, a banker's only child, he had everything a man could want, power, grace and style. But I work in his factory, and I curse the life I'm living, and I curse my poverty, and I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be Richard Cory. Papers print his picture almost everywhere he goes. Richard Cory at the opera, Richard Cory at a show, and the rumor of his parties and the orgies on his yacht. Oh, he surely must be happy with everything he's got. But I work in his factory, and I curse the life I'm living, and I curse my poverty, and I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be Richard Cory. He freely gave to charity, he had the common touch, and they were grateful for his patronage, and they thanked him very much. So my mind was filled with wonder when the evening headlines read Richard Cory went home last night and put a bullet through his head. But I work in his factory, and I curse the life I'm living, and I curse my poverty, and I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be Richard Cory.
Thank you. civilians, including women and children, were killed in the raid. George Raft, frontman of the Colony Club in London, is continuing his efforts to regain entry into Britain. Raft disclaims any association with the mafia, said to be infiltrating into London gaming society. Speaking in Hollywood, Raft said his business commitments in Britain are entirely honorable. Three men who want to see a fairer deal for ex-prisoners will go on hunger strike at Nelson Jail. The men are complaining about abusive treatment and say an interview they had with the governor was completely unsatisfactory. It's only 3 weeks since a riot at the jail brought increased security and removal of privileges. Dennis Stanford, playboy burglar, was jailed for life yesterday. He was found guilty at Newcastle of the murder of Angus Stuart Simmons. The jury took 3 hours to reach a verdict. Jailed at Whit Stafford, who was 33, was Michael Lavaglio of Newcastle on Tyne. Simmons was shot in his Mark 10 Jaguar on January the 4th. Aden, members of the National Liberation Movement, beat 2 Arabs to death in the streets of Crater today. They've been accused of conspiracy to undermine the movement's aims to remove British control from the protectorate. The men, both in their early 20s, were dragged and beaten for almost 20 minutes while police looked on helplessly.
Simon and Garfunkel Show, P562, Part 2, Take 1.
Okay, just stand by for the studio.
Time, see what's become of me. While I looked around for my possibilities, I was so hard to please. But look around, leaves are brown, and the sky is a hazy shade of winter. Hear the Salvation Army band down by the riverside's bound to be a better ride than what you've got planned. Carry your cup in your hand and look around. Leaves are brown now and the sky is a hazy shade of winter. Hang on to your hopes, my friend. That's an easy thing to say, but if your hopes should pass away, simply pretend that you can build them again. Look around, the grass is high, the fields are ripe, it's the springtime of my life. Seasons change with the scenery, weaving time in a tapestry. Won't you stop and remember me at any convenient time? Funny how my memory skips while looking over manuscripts of unpublished rhyme. Drinking my vodka and lime, I look around, leaves are brown now, and the sky is a hazy shade of winter. Look around, leaves are brown, there's a patch of snow on the ground. Look around, leaves are brown, there's a patch of snow on the ground. Look around, leaves are brown, there's a patch of snow on the ground.
This is an animal song of sorts. Called At the Zoo. Someone told me it's all happening at the zoo. I do believe it. I do believe it's true. Whoa, whoa. It's a light and tumble journey from the east side to the park. Just a fine and fancy ramble to the zoo. But you can take the crosstown bus if it's raining or it's cold. And the animals will love it if you do. If you do. Something tells me it's all happening at the zoo. I do believe that, I do believe it's true. The monkeys stand for honesty, giraffes are insincere, and the elephants are kindly, but they're dumb. Orangutans are skeptical of changes in their cages, and the zookeeper is very fond of rum. Zebras are reactionaries, antelopes are missionaries, pigeons plot in secrecy, and hamsters turn on frequently. What a gas! You got to come and see at the zoo. At the zoo. At the zoo.
Thank you. This is a song from our last album called Parsley, Sage, Rosemary, and Thyme, and the song is called Cloudy.
Cloudy, the sky is gray and white and cloudy. Sometimes I think it's hanging down on me. And it's a hitchhike 100 miles on a ragamuffin child. Pointed finger, painted smile. I left my shadow waiting down the road for me a while. Cloudy, my thoughts are scattered and they're cloudy. They have no borders, no boundaries. They echo and they swell from Tolstoy to Tinkerbell, down from Berkeley to Carmel. I got some pictures in my pocket and a lot of time to kill. Hey sunshine, I haven't seen you in a long time. Why don't you show your face and bend my mind? These clouds stick to the sky like a floating question why, and they linger there to die. They don't know where they're going, and my friend either do I. Cloudy, cloudy, cloudy,
cloudy. This is a song that is 400 years old. It's an adaptation of an Edwin Ar- of of a 16th century piece called Besame Mucho. 16th century piece that I researched in the library and wrote guitar chords to, and we do it as a two-part setting called Benedictus.
There's a controversy raging in the States now, or I suppose throughout the world. Well, anyway, on the front of a magazine cover, somebody wrote, "Is God dead?" You see, and then everybody debated the subject, particularly those people who sort of work for God, like in the church. And I was at a sermon that was given. Church in New York, in the village. A remarkable sermon, because it didn't say anything. See, and because the meek are inheriting nothing. And that's the basis of this song, called Blessed.
Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit. Blessed is the Lamb whose blood flows. Blessed are the sat upon, spat upon, ratted on. Forsaken me.
I got no place to go. I've walked around Soho for the last night or so. Ah, but it doesn't matter, no.
Blessed is the land and the kingdom. Blessed is the man whose soul belongs to. Blessed are the meth drinkers, pot sellers, illusion dwellers. Oh Lord, why have you forsaken me?
My words trickle down from a wound that I have no intention to heal.
Blessed are the stained glass window pane glass. Blessed is the church service makes me nervous. Blessed are the penny rookers, cheap hookers, groovy lookers. Oh Lord, why have you forsaken me?
I've tended my own garden much too long.
In 1964, we recorded our first album for Columbia Records, and we took about 400 photographs for the album cover in the subways in New York City, and all the shots were against the subway wall. And at the end of the session, to our great dismay, we noticed that what was written on the subway wall made all the shots impossible to be used on the cover of an album. The theme of people who write on subway walls, whether it be obscenity or just any sort of natural expression, has taken us capture both our interests, and we both treat the subject fairly seriously, as though the thing that's written is a poem, in that it is an expression sincerely felt by a person at the time, whether it be anger or whatever. And this song is written with that theme in mind, called A Poem on the Underground Wall.
The last train is nearly due. The underground is closing soon. And in the dark, deserted station, restless in anticipation, a man waits in the shadows. His restless eyes leap and scratch at all that they can touch or catch. Hidden deep within his pocket, safe within his silent socket, he holds a colored crayon. From the tunnel's stony womb, the carriage rides to meet the groom and opens wide and welcome doors, but he hesitates, then withdraws deeper in the shadow. And the train has gone suddenly, on wheels clicking silently, like a gently tapping litany. And he holds his crayon rosary tighter in his hand. Now from his pocket quick he flashes the crayon on the wall he slashes. Deep upon the advertising, a single worded poem comprised of four letters. And his heart is laughing, screaming, pounding, the poem across the tracks rebounding. Shadowed by the exit light, his legs take their ascending flight to seek the breast of darkness and be suckled by the night. Winter's day in a deep and dark December, I am alone, gazing from my window to the streets below on a freshly fallen silent shroud of snow. I am a rock, I am an I built walls, a fortress deep and mighty that none may penetrate. I have no need of friendship. Friendship causes pain. Its laughter and its loving I disdain. I am a rock, I am an well, I've heard the word before. It's sleeping in my memory. I won't disturb the slumber of feelings that have died. If I never loved, I never would have cried. I am a rock, I am an my books and my poetry to protect me. I am shielded in my armor, hiding in my room, safe within my womb. I touch no one and no one touches me. I am a rock, I am an and a rock feels no pain, and an island never cries.
Thank you. darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, 'neath the halo of a street lamp. I turned my collar to the cold and damp, when my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light that split the night and touched the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs that voices never share, and no one dare disturb the sound of silence. "Fool," said I, "you do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words, like silent raindrops, fell and echoed in the well of silence. And the people bowed and prayed to the neon god they made. And the sign flashed its warning in the words that it was forming. And the sign said, the words of the prophets are written on the subway walls and tenement halls, whispered in the sounds of silence.